Happy and energetic day, dear children. I welcome you all to the English Corner. Children, what we are going to learn today is chapter 7, a new chapter, right? Before you read, I'm not going to say the name of the lesson, right? Who are the oldest people you know? You have to say me, who are the oldest people you know? Maybe your grandfather, great grandfather, okay? So, whoever you know, you can share it. What are the oldest things you have in your house? Oldest things in your city, in your town or village. How old are they? Right? So, what are the oldest things you have in your house? Maybe I remember... Instead of mixie, we will grind using a stone, isn't it? That is there in my grandmother's home. I don't know how many years old it is. Maybe around 100 years. So, how old are they? That also you have to share, right? So, what are the oldest things you have in your house, in your city, town or village? How old are they? Have you ever wished that you were older? No, no. We would like to be the youngest only, right? What you like, children? You want to become old or you want to become young itself? So that you have to share it with me. And have you wished that you could grow up in a hurry? Have you wished that you could grow up in a hurry? Yes. Definitely yes. Children will wish that they have to complete 10th plus 2, all that. Then they have to go fast to college just to enjoy. But then they doesn't know the real pressure in college, right? So here, who are the oldest people you know? What are the oldest things you have in your house, in your city, town or village? How old are they? Have you ever wished that you were older? Have you wished that you could grow up in a hurry? So these are the questions raised to you, and you have to share the answers with me, dear. And shall we move into the lesson? Right. So the topic of the lesson is the invention of Vita Onk. What is the topic? The invention of Vita Onk. This is the 7th chapter. The author of this lesson is Roald Dahl. Roald Dahl. Right? So here, can you able to see a picture? Willy Wonka, the chocolate factory. All these are the famous books written by Roald Dahl. Right? So, shall we enter? We'll see about the author first. Roald Dahl is the author of the lesson, The Invention of Vita Onk. Roald Dahl, 13 September 1916. He was born on 13 September 1916 and expired on 23 November 1990. He was a British novelist. He was a short story writer, poet, fighter pilot and screenwriter. See how good he is. British novelist, short story writer, poet, fighter pilot and screenwriter. He was born in Wales to Norwegian parents. He served in the Royal Air Force during World War II, in which he became a flying ace. An intelligence officer, risking to the rank of wing commander. So, it is really a tough and responsible post in World War II. Dahl rose to prominence in the 1940s with the work for both children and adults. He used to write for children as well as adults and became one of the world's best-selling authors. He has been referred to as one of the greatest storytellers for the children of 20th century, right? So this is about Roald Dahl. He is multi-talented and he worked as a pilot also, and he was a story writer, greatest storyteller. See what happens is, so who is writing the best, he will not have the capacity of saying the story, but he had both the capacities, storytelling and story writing. He's very talented. He's fighter pilot also in Royal Air Force during World War II. So good. That is what about author Mr. Willy Wonka, the scientist. So Willy Wonka, it's nothing but a fictional character in Roald Dahl's 1964 children's novel. So what is the novel name? Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. That is what is a picture I showed you before. Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Its sequel, Charlie and the Great Glass Elevator, and the film adaptation of these books that followed. The book and the film adaptation both vividly depict on Odd Wonka, a feature arising from his creative and eccentric genius. So Willy Wonka is a character. He likes a character. He bewilders the other characters with his antics, but Charlie enjoys Wonka's behavior. In 2005 film adaptation, Willy Wonka's behavior is viewed more as a sympathetic character, that is flaw character, character of flaws. Wonka's reason for going away his fabulous factory is never revealed, either in the book or in the film, 1971 film adaptation. Many speculate the reason that Wonka was terminally ill. So this is what about Willy Wonka, the character. This is not there in the book, just an extra information for you to know about Mr. Willy Wonka, right? So Mr. Willy Wonka, now only in your book the session starts, right? Mr. Willy Wonka begins by inventing Wonka wit. So it is nothing but a small drink which makes people younger. What that drink will do, if you drink that Wonka wit, you will become younger. But Wonka wit is too strong, so some people disappear, right? Disappear in the sense because of their age becomes minus. So if you are 11 years, right, 11 years old, and if you drink that Wonka Vita, you will become minus 12 or minus 87. Sometimes that is you're not at all born. Okay. So that is what is Mr. Willy Wonka begins by inventing Wonka Vita, which makes people younger. But Wonka Vita is too strong, so some people disappear because of their ages become minus. So one person actually becomes minus 87 years back in his life, right? Which means he has got to wait 87 years before he can come back. So Mr. Willy Wonka must invent a new thing. So that is what is an introduction about Mr. Wonka. Mr. Wonka said, so once again, I rolled up my sleeves and he set to work. Once again, I squeezed my brain. He's squeezing his brain, searching for the new recipe. For what? I had to create age to make people old. He created a Wonka Vita, which makes the people younger. Now he wanted to make a drink which makes the people old. Right? Old. Older. Oldest. Ha ha ha, I cried. For now the ideas were beginning to come. What are the ideas? When you search something, automatically the information will reach to you in any sort of way. So the mind has a power and your thinking has a power, and you will search on that. So the information will come to you automatically. See here, Onkavita, he wants to introduce or invent a drink which makes the people older, right? For that, he's searching. What is the oldest living thing in the world? He's searching for the oldest living thing in the world. Why? He wants to create a drink which makes the people older. So he wants to use the thing, oldest living thing in the world. What lives longer than anything else? When I think longer than anything else in the world, we'll think of mountains, seas, forest, something like that. Okay. So, Charlie said, a tree. A tree. Right, you are Charlie. Right. So, but what kind of a tree? So many trees are there. What kind of a tree? Not the Douglas fir. Douglas fir is a type of a tree. Not the oak. Not the cedar. No, no, bye-bye. It is a tree called... See, what is a tree? This is what is a tree, and where the tree was grown is here in this map. Let us see in the next slide. Right? It is a tree called the bristlecone pine that grows upon the slopes of Wheeler Peak in Nevada, USA. You can find bristlecone pines on Wheeler Peak today that are over 4,000 years old. Okay, so ancient bristlecone pine forest is this one tree that is 4,000 years old. This is fact, Charlie. Ask any dendrochronologist you like. What is a dendrochronologist? You're looking so blank, isn't it? So we'll see what is dendrochronology. It is a noun. It is a science dealing with the study of annual rings of trees in determining the dates and chronological order of past event. So those who are doing dendrochronology are called dendrochronologist. The person who is working on the study of annual rings of the trees, they are called as dendrochronologist. You can see the rings. This is a tree, right? Log of tree. So the center dot is a first year growth. Then if it is rainy season, the tree will grow in a little bit thicker. That is why here the space is bigger. This ring is alone bigger because of rainy season. If it is dry season, it will be very thin because water will not be sufficient. Excess water, the ring is thicker. That is how they will find it here. Scar from forest fire. Suppose any accident happened, fire, then the tree was burned. So this is the scar from forest fire. Even that we can able to identify. Right? Here, spring or early summer growth will be appeared like this. And the late summer fall growth. So all these differentiation can be clearly mentioned by the dendrochronologist by seeing the tree itself. Right? So, dendrochronologist. So, ask any dendrochronologist you like and look at the word up in the dictionary when you get home. Will you please? Yes, I gave full dictionary meaning to you now. So, that started me off. I jumped into the great glass elevator and rushed all over the world collecting special items from the oldest living things. Right? So now, what are the oldest living things here? A pint of sap from a 4,000 year old bristlecone pine. So this is what is 4,000 year bristlecone pine. A pint of sap, small sap. Then, what is this? Very big toenail. This is a toenail clipping from a 168-year-old Russian farmer called Petrovich Grigorovich. Okay, dear, time is up. We'll see in the next session.